Millions of Americans got letters from the IRS in the fall of 2021. I don't know about you, but I know that every time I get something unexpected from the IRS, I freak out a little bit. So if that's you, take a deep breath and we'll go over the five things you should do if you got one of these letters. First, don't panic. The majority of people who got a letter got a CP12 letter. And this is essentially like the Monopoly card that says there was a bank error in your favor. This is actually good news. It means that the IRS says that they owe you money. A CP12 letter is one of the two types of math error letters that the IRS sends out. In a typical year, they send out about 2 million of these math error letters, but in 2021, they've sent out 11 million of these letters. A CP11 letter is the opposite of a CP12 letter, and it means that you owe the IRS more money than you originally stated on your return. Some people also got a 6470 letter. This letter is just a notice of your rights to appeal changes to changes that the IRS made to your account. This probably came after you got a CP11 or CP12 letter earlier. But the good news is the majority of people are getting CP12 letters where the IRS wants to pay you more money. All right, step two, read your letter very carefully. It should explain what changes were made to your 2020 return. 80% of the letters going out right now state that you didn't claim a recovery rebate credit that you were owed. Recovery rebate credit is the official name of the stimulus checks. The IRS sent out 3 recovery rebate credits total, and 2 of them were in 2020. If you didn't receive one or both of the checks in 2020 that you were owed, you were supposed to claim that on your 2020 return. But a lot of people didn't realize they were owed some money and they didn't claim these rebates on their 2020 taxes. The IRS is just now telling you that they owe you money and they're going to send you an extra check. Step 3, after you've read your letter, if you're still confused about what's going on with your refund, I recommend logging into your IRS account and checking your IRS transcript. Make sure that you're doing this on the real IRS website. I'll put the URL on the screen down below so you can make sure that you're going to the right place. When you log in there on the IRS site, you'll be able to see a history of everything that's happened on your account, and it'll give you a little bit more information. All right, step 4. If you think the IRS has made a mistake with this change, and only if you think they've made a mistake, then you're going to want to file an appeal. You do have only 60 days to file an appeal. You can do this in writing or over the phone. I would strongly advise doing this in writing because very few people are getting through to the IRS on the phone lately. One estimate stated that in the first half of 2021, only about 8% of callers to the IRS were actually getting through and talking to someone. And I've heard from plenty of people who spent hours waiting on the phone to talk to the IRS, and then the person just read back the letter that they already received or told them to log on to their online account. Remember though that you only need to contact the IRS to file an appeal if you think they've made a mistake. So step 5, if you are comfortable with the changes the IRS is making to your return, you just have to wait for your check or direct deposit to come. Officially, the checks are supposed to come in 4 to 6 weeks after the letter, but I've heard of people waiting up to 4 months in 2021 to get their checks. Unfortunately, everything is just really slow right now. So for most people who got these letters, if you got a CP12, that is the good news kind of letter, and all you have to do is sit back and wait for your check to come. I know letters from the IRS are scary, but this time it's good news for most people. Next up, check out this other great video that I know you're gonna love.